In what follows, I will be presenting a guided meditation on recollection of death. And by way of introduction, I want to briefly describe what we will be doing so that you are prepared, and also say a few words on the significance of this type of practice. So the practice I'll be introducing is particularly suitable for the lying down posture, the corpse posture. And we will begin with a short reflection on all the things that on dying we need to leave behind. Then use the four elements: earth, water, fire and wind. Earth standing for the quality of solidity and hardness. Water for liquidity, cohesion. Fire for warmth, different degrees of temperature. And wind for motion. Using these four elements to relate to different stages in the actual process of dying. And these four elements also relate to the falling apart of the body after death. And we'll be going through this in some detail. And then eventually come to two aspects of the practice that relate to other bodily postures. One is using the breath, which is particularly suitable for sitting meditation. And the other is the felt sense of the skeleton inside of our own body, which is particularly apt for relating recollection of death to the standing and the walking posture. And the skeleton can also be used as a visual image. I have a skeleton always with me. It's usually where I meditate as a constant reminder of mortality. Even though I will be presenting this practice in much detail, afterwards, when we do this for ourselves, it is important that we adjust according to our personal needs and requirements. At times, there may be things happening in our personal life that render the initial reflections on all the things and beloved ones we have to leave behind something that we might prefer to skip. Also, the stages of decomposition of the body can be rather strong, and there may be times when it is better not to use these. We have mindfulness to alert us to what is appropriate, and we adjust our practice accordingly, not pushing too hard, not forcing ourselves, but at the same time keeping up with this practice. Recollection of death is something to be done every day. It is so incredibly important for us to work with this particular practice. We are all going to die. There's no question about that. And it is perhaps natural, but actually not such a good idea if we don't prepare for it. we don't start studying only on the day of the examination. We don't start exercising our muscles only on the day of competition. Similarly, it is not a good idea to prepare for death only at the time when we are actually dying. Who knows what situation we may be in? We may be sick. There may be unresolved problems. Others who are dying, crying. A very stressful situation. It is better now to take time regularly to train ourselves in the art of dying, to get ready for what we anyway have to face. There's a whole branch of cognitive psychology that studies the ways we human beings tend to ignore our own mortality. It is called terror management theory. The theory of how we manage our existential terror. Like all animals, we have the survival instinct. But we differ from them with the knowledge that we will ultimately not be successful. This tension between these two creates terror, existential terror. And terror management theory has been able to show a whole range of defense mechanisms employed to ignore the fact of our mortality. Basically, there are two main thrusts. One is to somehow pretend that death doesn't really affect me, and the other one is to push it off into the future. Simply said, it's not me, and anyway, not now. So the two practices that I suggest to take into sitting and standing and walking meditation, based on the first part that we'll be doing, are meant to address precisely these two, to drive home the fact that death is about me dying. In particular, the practice of the breath, to make it clear that we cannot be sure when death will take place, and it could even happen right now. We can't be completely sure. And besides preparing ourselves for the actual time of dying, this practice also prepares us for the time of living. When we become aware of our mortality, it puts our whole life into perspective. What is really important? What are the things that I want to do before I have to leave? Our priorities get clarified. We easily forgive and ask for forgiveness. We become more alive through recollection of death. And recollection of death is facing ignorance head on. There's nothing human beings like to ignore as much as the fact of their own mortality. Ignorance is the main problem from a Buddhist perspective. And so it is no surprise that recollection of death can lead to the deathless, to awakening. And in Buddhist thought, the deathless is not something to be realized after one has passed away. The deathless is realized while still alive, here and now. So it is a very powerful practice of insight meditation, vipassana. And it is a very powerful way of bringing an inner tranquility and calmness into our life. If we learn to face death, it gives so much inner peace. And we are able to face our own death and that of others with composure and understanding. There's a little poetic saying that I owe to my friend John Kabat-Zinn. I've slightly adjusted it, but it nicely fits the main thrust of this practice. Those who die before they die no longer die when they die. I think I've said enough now by way of introduction, and I would invite you to find a place so that you can lie down in the corpse posture. Use any yoga mat or mattress, whatever it is. And if you are meditating together with others, just make sure that you don't have any bodily contact with others, and that the bodily posture is as relaxed and comfortable as possible, lying on the back. And there's a little tool that I like to recommend for any meditation done in the prone posture, in the lying down posture. And this is to keep the lower half of one arm raised up horizontally. So the upper half of the arm still rests on the ground, on the elbow. And on the elbow, the lower half is raised up. It doesn't take any effort, as the weight naturally rests on the elbow. But what happens is that if we get even a little bit sleepy or tired, the arm will drop to one direction or the other, or it will start to collapse. So keeping the arm up in a very relaxed manner is a very helpful way for us to notice when the mind just starts to slightly doze off. We lose clarity, because that is the main challenge in the lying down posture, to keep the alertness of the mind, simply because we are so used to use that posture for sleeping. So if you have found a posture for you, a place to lie down in the corpse posture, and maybe keep that lower half of one arm raised up in a relaxed manner, just to make sure we don't fall into the ignorance of sleepiness, but that we are alert and awake. And we start by becoming aware of the whole body as it is lying on the ground. And if you wish, as part of that whole body awareness, also aware of the natural process of breathing. Not as something that we focus on to the exclusion of everything else, but just as part of this whole body awareness. And we relax the body, letting it as if we're sinking into the ground. And at times, in order to encourage this relaxation, we may just briefly tense it up, like for a moment, tense up the legs and relaxing them. Tense up the arms and relaxing them. Tense up the shoulders and relaxing them. And finally, tense up the facial muscles and relaxing. The continuity of whole body awareness, awareness of the whole body in this very relaxed condition and in the corpse posture. Thank you. as we keep gradually coming out of our meditation, coming out of the corpse posture, we maintain awareness of the skeleton inside of our own body. Whole body awareness with particular attention to the skeleton as something that we can use for the continuity of practice with any activities. Perhaps we may feel now it is time to go a little bit outside and be at the fresh air. Or we may decide to sit, in which case we can work with the breath. Awareness of our own mortality conjoined to the breath. Sitting, lying, walking, standing, we continue step by step, gradually, but with consistency and dedication, to walk the path to the deathless.